if you notice on the left hand side there's that long bar going from top to bottom, that's how much of the track you've completed. So it actually shows you.
Just a bit of stunt driving here and there now.
And actually it does show you how close you are to the finish line.
Yeah.
My car is pretty much unusable right now. So you can tell where you...
Oh, that's cool.
We'll show another race, another track that they have. So they give you quite a lot of options in terms of replay, which is nice.
Let's choose another track, see how we get on there.
I don't know, I'm not feeling the style. Oh, I don't know.
The actual look of it, you mean?
Look of it,
yeah. I think with this type of game where, you know, the actual with the controls you have to be really intricate, I think the more classy kind of menu look works with it better. Whereas with a game like Burnout, more action orientated, this more kind of wacky, out there kind of look suits that better.
Exactly.
That's what I tend to think. I mean, with simulation games, the classy.
It doesn't suit. Like, when Gran Turismo 5 comes out, we all know it's going to have these really slick, like almost chrome looking menus. It's like really simple. It's the circuits are all off road in set stadiums, arenas, and open landscapes. You will battle with up to 7 other drivers in a land rush start. Tracks are real tight and packed with jumps, drops, and bangs. Your eligible vehicles include trophy trucks. You can see in the corner you also some sort of XP system going on in the game, which probably generally means you get to unlock different things at different levels. Okay, so I think it's going to be a different car now for this race.
Interesting.
Apparently the new engine that they built for DiRT 1 allowed them to have these kind of menus.
Okay.
Obviously any game can pull it off, but it's just the way they've done it. It's actually, even here, even while you're in the menus, they're telling you how many miles you've done in the game. It just basically shows you stats.
It's cooking, and Sam seems to get everywhere.
It's quite difficult to say for this game how it plays, because really every single car plays differently.
Definitely. This one much heavier.
Really does.
This bigger car is much heavier and steering is slightly delayed.
I have to give it the graphics for this game.
The graphics are absolutely amazing, I've got to say. Pretty detailed.
Okay, so they're doing a kind of Need for Speed banter back and forth, which is alright.
That boat on the left, wicked.
They're also saying that the online for this version is improved drastically with the first one.
Okay.
I played the first one, it was basically, they said that it's 100 players in online, and that was true, it was 100, you do race against 100 players, but those 100 players aren't all on the screen.
Okay.
It's 100 players playing simultaneously on their own, on the track, but then at the end of it, whoever's got the best time shows up. But now I think they're saying it's around 16 players or something like that.
That's pretty good.
8 or 16 players you can have actually on screen this time. With a lot of people complaining that there wasn't that much of a challenge and that competitive nature wasn't there.
You see the glare effects in the water as well. Amazing to see.
So far, I think this is an excellent example of a sequel It's been a good amount of time before the since the game was released originally, and they've improved. I mean, already we can see they've improved on it a lot.
Gameplay-wise, definitely is amazing.
Yeah,
they've improved it quite a bit. Place, not bad for my first time.
I think there's only six places. No, there's like
eight places. Alright guys,
okay, so
hope you enjoyed those two races.
Yep. Overall, personally, minus the user interface, it's basically DiRT 1. If you love DiRT 1, you're going to love this. There weren't that many cars in this demo, but there's going to be tons of them in the full game. And
a lot of new tracks as well, hopefully.
Yeah. So yeah, if you like this, definitely, you know, if you've got the opportunity to download the demo, give it a try, and
just enjoy the graphics as well as the gameplay. I mean, yeah. Graphics probably one of the best I've seen in a racing game,
definitely.
Along with PGR, I'd say.
Yeah.
So yeah, check it out. Hope you enjoy the quick look and stay tuned for our newer videos. See ya.